إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. My dear viewers of Guidance TV, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm your host, Karim AbuZaid, coming to you live from Denver, Colorado, to answer your questions and hopefully share a message with you today. And the message is, if Ramadan is gone, the Lord of Ramadan is always here. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is a habit in the Ummah now. As soon as Ramadan departs, the Muslims, they give up the houses of Allah. They give up the ibadah. As if they got a certificate of forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us on the tongue of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that if we fast Ramadan out of iman, out of belief, out of ihtisab, seeking the reward, our sins will be forgiven. And he also promised us subhanahu wa ta'ala on the tongue of our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that if we stand in qiyam, salatu tarawih, at night, iman and again, out of belief, ihtisab and again, seeking the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive our previous sins. Rather, one night, the night of Laylatul Qadr, which is in the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also promised us on the tongue of our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whosoever observes عبادة on the night of ليلة القدر out of إيمان again, believe, and seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all his previous sins. So let's say that you got that. I mean, there is no guarantees, and I will go back and visit this point quickly. But let's say that you got your forgiveness. Does this mean that you give up the ibadah? Absolutely not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters in Islam, in the Quran, addressed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, telling him, إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. The meanings of which, the first verse in Surah Al-Fath, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your previous and your future sins, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But at the same time, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one that we're talking about, his past and his future sins are forgiven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him in the Quran at the end of Surah Al-Hijr, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. And worship your Lord, O Muhammad. Keep up with the ibadah, O Muhammad, until you die. As a matter of fact, in the two sahih hadith, Aisha radiallahu anha, she noticed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam standing in, for tahajjud at night, to the extent that his feet were swollen, whatever the word is. She asked him this question, why are you doing this to yourself, O Messenger of Allah? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven your past and your future sins, You know what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to his beloved wife, brothers and sisters in Islam, Aisha radiallahu anha, Ya Aisha, O Aisha, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Shouldn't I be a grateful servant of Allah? Ya Allah, this statement is out of this world. Let's say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven your sins. Shouldn't you be grateful? And you show that gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by maintaining, carrying on the worship of Allah. Compare the masajid now, brothers and sisters in Islam, and the masajid in Ramadan. You will find that even those who quit it, even those who retired from the houses of Allah, they are not being grateful to Allah. They are not. At least be grateful. I go back to the point that I promised to visit as I begin, inshallah. Hopefully the number is shown on the screen now, so you can call us, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. There is no guarantees that you were forgiven. You were forgiven. This verse in Surah Al-Mu'minun, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the attributes of the believers. And one of their attributes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. And those who do what they do, while their hearts are trembling, they are in a state of fear that they may be returning to Allah subhanahu, they will be returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aisha radiallahu anha fi sunan al-Imam al-Tirmidhi asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, does this verse, O Messenger of Allah, talk about those who commit adultery, those who steal, those who kill, and they are afraid that they will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them for these major sins? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answers Aisha radiallahu anha, telling her, La ya Aisha, no Aisha, La ya bint al-Siddiq, no ya daughter of al-Siddiq. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse is talking about the believers who perform salah, perform zakah, perform hajj, and they are afraid that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not accept from them. That should be the feeling, brothers and sisters in Islam.